Hello and welcome to the presentation of the prototype of the Advertising Over Time project. It is an interactive machine learning system where you can perform analysis on extracted labels from advertising data. When you open the tool, you start with the clustering view where you can perform clustering analysis on the dataset. To start, we have to import a dataset. To do this, we click on the Load Data button and then we can choose a dataset path up there in the Choose Dataset dialog. Once we specified the path where the dataset lies, the dataset will be analyzed and we can see the advertisement size of that dataset as well as the filtered dataset size, because we can perform filtering on the dataset to get a data subset that we are interested in. We can set the lower boundary of the time span as well as the upper boundary, and the filtered dataset size will always get updated in real time. We can also choose the category that the advertisement should lie in. At the moment we have automotive as the only option because we loaded a data set that only contains automotive advertisements. We can also choose a key object. A key object means that it's an object of interest. We get a list of all the objects in the current advertisement set, sorted by their magnitude. And for example, if we select car, we then get the amount of car in each advertisement, as well as the average size of that car. We will choose car because we have an automotive dataset and we are interested therefore in cars. So now that we successfully loaded up the dataset, the first thing we see is the graph at the bottom that displays the importance of the certain features on the dataset structure. So it shows how dissimilar the data entities are in each feature. For example, we have the person to object ratio. The entities are the most dissimilar in this feature. Then we have second place the year and third the car average size in the image. We can also choose between numerical, class attributes and binary attributes, because binary attributes are either 0 or 1 in their distance, and therefore the complete average distance will always be higher than with the numerical attributes. So based on this graph, the user can for example decide in which features he's interested in and can then select those features in the clustering view above. Up there in the list we can see the features that we can filter in clustering. We have the numerical attributes, the class attributes, the binary attributes and the meta attributes, which are also numerical features and are being calculated from the original features of the advertisement. We also see the car average size and number of car. This comes from the key object car that we chose initially. We can also select that for clustering. So let's choose some features that we are interested in, for example year, number of words and maybe logo and claim. Now here we have the star coordinate view of the current dataset with the chosen features. Each feature has its own axis. For the axis we can change the length and the angle of it, and we see what kind of an impact each feature has on the dataset structure. The lighting of the data entities is actually dependent from the mouse position, so it helps the user to focus more on interesting points due to the shading of the data entities. Now what we can do if we want to perform clustering, the tool can assist us in finding a meaningful amount of clusters. Over there we can set a range where the tool should calculate the optimal clustering within, so we will set a range between 2 and 10, and then we can calculate the number of clusters. Once this is finished, the tool will propose a number of 4 clusters. Seen as optimal, we can also see the different results of the clusterings from 2 to 10. It's based on the silhouette value to evaluate the single clusterings. With the slider, we can also visualize all the different steps of the calculation. If necessary, the user can also utilize visualization provided by the tool. The tool tries to give an optimal visualization for the current clustering. So if you calculated a clustering, you can also see a evaluation graph on the right, where we can see the cluster cardinality plotted against the cluster magnitude, so the actual number of entities in a cluster plotted against the distance to the centroid, and all the objects should lie on the middle line for a perfect result. On the bottom we can choose a cluster, we can also select this by clicking on it. It gets highlighted then, as you can see. A highlighted cluster can then be exported. We can also export the complete clustering. We can also change the name of an interesting cluster we selected and change that name. And if we select a cluster, we get the mean values displayed as well as sample advertisements. It is also possible to inspect each single data entity of the dataset. To do this, we just have to double-click on the data entity. And then the dialog showing the actual advertisement will open. On the left, we can display the detected bounding boxes of persons, faces, and objects in different colors. We can also click on a bounding box, and then it will show that it is a car. And we can also move the bounding box to maybe correct the position of it. If we click a face, for example, then we can see it's a female that is happy, and we see it's not a celebrity, and we see the estimated age span. If you move bounding boxes, we can also always reset them. The fields marked in green can always be changed. We see the extracted information as well as the extracted scenery and the calculated information from the original values. We can't change this. The cluster view also offers a dual view, so we can hit dual and then we can actually change to the second by this, and then we can choose other features and compare this to the left view. We could also here then choose clustering, mean shift, and just calculate clustering, and you would get like a different clustering that you could compare. Once we are finished with clustering analysis, we can head over to the time series graph, where we can evaluate the development of certain features over time. For example, number of words, number of persons, number of celebrities. We see the development over time. We can also see the maxima, the minima, and the variance, together with the corresponding years. We can also choose different data sets to display the development of the features and compare them. We can also see correlations. For example, the first one, the number of objects is correlated with number of cars. This means the more objects we have in the advertisements, the more cars there are. This means that most objects are cars. We can also compare different data sets in a dual view of the time series graph. Lastly, we can head over to the rule view, which can show a more condensed version of the facts we gathered in the analysis before. We can here display different clusters and show the temporal distribution of that cluster over time. We can also choose the time distribution of that cluster as an important fact. You can see that the current cluster lies in this time span with a compact scattering. We can also choose some important correlations. For example, from before, the number of objects is correlated with a number of car. We get this displayed in a sentence where it says that the more objects there are, the more cars we have. Or for example, number of persons is correlated with women to men ratio. This means if more persons, then there are also more women. We can export this as a text. So that's it from the presentation of the prototype. Thank you for watching and goodbye.